After threatening for a continued period of time, Funyula MP Paul Otuoma finally relinquished his position as the vice chairman of ODM on Saturday.
Mimi kama vice chairman, kama naongea vitu na unapuuza, kuna haja ya mimi kuwa vice chairman? Sasa mnataka niwache hiyo vitu? Niwache? Niwache? Kuanzia leo mimi nimejiuzulu kama vice chairman ya ODM.
Party Secretary General Ababu Namwamba threatened to follow suit if issues afflicting the party are not addressed.
Tumesema waziwazi peupe, without prevarication, circumlocution or any shade of doubt, ya kwamba ikiwa ndoto zetu hazina nafasi ya kutimika katika chama cha ODM, tutafanya nini? Tutajipanga.
Aliye na sikio asikie. Aliye na macho aone. ODM ni chama ambaye imeshikana pamoja. Tena ni chama ambaye inadumisha demokrasia kindani. Ndani ya chama chetu hakuna udikteta. Wale ambao wanaongea udikteta ni wale ambao wanaota ndoto.
As expected, these developments at ODM have attracted the attention of political observers. According to pundits, ODM leader Raila Odinga cannot ignore the two legislators.
If I were Raila for now, I would just say, guys, let's sit down. Let's talk. Because wishing them away is wishing his candidature and his political career into complete jeopardy. It is like saying, I do not want to vie in 2017.
In terms of perception, it's very damaging, because if you are losing people every other day, then there's a problem with you. Yeah, Raila has lost virtually every other serious foot soldier he had.
But what exactly informs the revolt by the two outspoken legislators?
The people of Western, region, are of this belief that really is not them that needs ODM, but ODM needs them. Remember, this is the second biggest tribe in Kenya. And of course, I am sure what they're looking at is a situation where they want to build themselves as a region, come up with a proper political party that maybe can negotiate before the elections or after the elections for them to have a national cake.
There has been fatigue. The fatigue had set in because the Luhya Nation has voted for him twice, but he doesn't reach the desired destination. So the fatigue has set in, and he has also not been very good at trying to keep his side of the bargain.
Na ndio mimi naambia nyinyi watu wa Busia, au wa Luhya kwa jumla, sisi tumedharauliwa wa Luhya wote. Hata pana Busia peke yake.
And will the two leaders incur any political consequence if they were to call it quits?
This is also giving him mileage and a bargaining power in the Western politics. Because already he's being seen nationally as this kind of a person who can even take the bull on its own, you know, which most of the Kenyan politicians and leaders don't do. It's very hard for you to find someone within the party, or even the Jubilee Party, where you see someone coming out very strongly and trying also, to question the leadership of even the president of Uhuru Kenyatta. So when Ababu Namwamba is coming and saying there is a problem within ODM, of course he's being seen within the Western province like a man with a muscle.
According to political analysts Martin Andati and John Mushemi, if the two called it a day at the orange outfit, this could portend yet another serious adult to Odinga's quest for presidency.
The moment Raila loses the Luhya bloc, he becomes a very weak presidential candidate. In fact, the most strategic thing now for him to do is to start shopping around for somebody he can endorse. Because his strength has been hinged on the Luhya Luo bloc.
Odinga has, however, blamed all exoduses from the opposition to its political nemesis, Jubilee. On the other hand, Jubilee is banking on its development record as a reason for discontent in the opposition strongholds. Whether Odinga sees this as a real concern or just another unnecessary noise remains a question on everyone's mind. Eric Biegon reporting for Channel One News.